Now, the authorities in Chikuwe District in Western Uganda have suspended money-lending businesses in the district on account of what they say are increasing cases of innocent members of the public being fleeced of their hard-earned money as well as property. As you'll hear, our correspondent there says most affected are women, especially widows who have had their property and a lot more money taken by the unforgiving moneylenders. Let's take a look.
The Chikuwe LC5 boss Peter Banura and the resident district commissioner Amlan Tumusime secured property belonging to five women which had been confiscated by money lenders. The affected women include the 45 Agnes Tuhaise, Tusabe Muhereza 64, Yasinta Harwa and Olivia Chiza 44, all residents of Buhimba Town Council. Their property had been confiscated by one moneylender identified as Johnson Kagoma. Tuhaise says that she borrowed 6 million Ugandan shillings from Kagoma and used her 3 acres of land with a house as collateral security. However, after paying 3 million shillings, Kagoma refused to take the balance from her and decided to take the land, claiming he had bought it.
Rumba Muhammad na unajia na angamba kwe, wamanyi, na anka kasoma, kwende sentez, za siga ile, agambi, tugende hamu.
However, Amlan Tumusime, the Chikuwe RDC says the women were evicted from their lands without any court order.
Money lenders have been conniving with some LC1 share persons, giving them stamps on fake sales agreements. Someone borrows somebody 1 million for a property and the chairman also wants stamps that that person has sold, has bought that property, either land or house. At the end of the day, someone loses a property worth 30 million because of a mere 1 million shillings. So I have instructed all LC1 share persons in Chikuwe district to stop forthwith stamping on any sales agreement, the so-called in quotes sales agreement, especially where money lenders are involved.
Tumusime vowed not to tolerate such impunity and called on money lenders to use legal means of recovering their monies than confiscating people's property illegally. He directed the LC1 chairpersons to stop stamping this bank and Tambula arguments that are not registered.
We have a very big problem. Money lenders in Chikuwe are targeting mostly women. I think they find them very soft people to handle. Many women are crying tears. Today it was a very bad experience. Old women, 70 years, 80 years, 60 years, crying because they are losing the properties to fake money lenders. We took a decision as a district to have these people go back and repossess their property. Because one, the money lenders never followed the law. There's no any court order speaking otherwise or ordering otherwise. Someone just wakes up in the morning, says, I gave you my money, I bought this property, but buying in quotes.
Peter Banura, the district chairman, asked the public who have lost their property in such manner to report to his office for intervention.
A one family of Mr. Nyabongo with his sons, Kagoma and others, they have terrorized the area. And what hurts most is they're terrorizing their own residents, their own people they have grown up with in the same village. This really hurt everybody so much. The outcries from the villagers were too many that we had to intervene as leaders.
Story compiled by Ismail Kasoha for the news, Chikuwe.